What up, Buzzards? Hope you all had an amazing holiday weekend. I'm Sapphire, and you're watching Toon Buzz on Channel Frederator. Today we're talking about Obama's visit to DreamWorks, Frozen, and Ernest and Celestine. LA drivers noticed traffic was significantly worse last week on Tuesday because President Obama stopped by DreamWorks Animation Studio in Glendale. Nearly 2,000 gathered to hear the president give props to the entertainment industry for creating job opportunities and being one of the bright spots of our economy. He joked that he would one day like to work for DreamWorks and that his ears were the inspiration for Shrek. Obama also said the gap between what we can do and what other countries can do is enormous. But then why are so many animation and visual effects jobs being outsourced to other countries? Outside of the studio, a group of about 50 ralliers, donned in green, were protesting the foreign subsidies that are driving visual effects jobs to other countries, and subsequently bankrupting top award-winning studios such as Rhythm and Hues and Digital Domain. Disney, on the other hand, is raking in the cold hard cash with their latest animated film, Frozen, which had one of the largest Thanksgiving opening weekends of all time. This CG musical follows a young girl on a journey to stop her sister from keeping the kingdom in eternal winter. I haven't seen the film yet, and honestly wasn't really looking forward to it because Olaf looked really annoying. But then, Emily the Brave of Channel Frederator Network gave Frozen a raving review, which you can watch right here. Plus, it snagged an A+ at CinemaScore, and the music is written by Robert Lopez, who scored the music of some of my favorite musicals, such as Avenue Q and Book of Mormon. So I've definitely warmed up to the idea that this film could possibly restore my faith in the Disney musical genre. If you're afraid traditionally animated movies are on their way to extinction, this might make you believe again. New York-based indie distributor G-Kids has announced that they'll be distributing the English dub version of Ernest and Celestine on March 14th. Of next year. Ernest and Celestine is a charmingly hand-drawn film about the mice who live beneath the streets and fear the bears who live above the ground. Both worlds are turned on their heads when a mouse befriends a bear. The dub version will have an impressive lineup of voice actors, which includes Forrest Whitaker, Paul Giamatti, Megan Mullally, and Mackenzie Foy. And with its recent SESAR award for Best Animated Feature, it could give other potential Oscar nominees a run for their money. The style is definitely refreshing and makes the film look straight out of a children's book. It also kind of reminded me of those Charmin commercials with the bears, except with a lot less butts. I'm putting this movie on my to-watch list. The nominees for the Annie Awards have also been announced, and Frozen and Ernest and Celestine are both up for Best Animated Feature. Monsters University and Frozen both have 10 nominations, while The Croods and Despicable Me 2 have 9. For a full list of all the nominees, as well as more information about the rest of these stories, the links are in the description below. If you've seen Frozen, what did you think? If not, do you plan on seeing it? Leave your spoiler-free answers in the comments below. I originally wasn't planning on seeing this movie because the original trailers weren't appealing to me. I thought that the side characters were a little bit obnoxious. But after hearing so much positive feedback from all of my friends who really enjoy the movie, I'm convinced now and I'm gonna go see it this week and I'm really excited.